A year later, Sapphire Rose, or as her family now called her, Sapphire Sword, lived in animated New York, where she lived in the sewers with her adopted father and four mutant turtle brothers, Leonardo, Donatello, Raphael, and Michelangelo, where she trained with them and fought many bad guys alongside. However, as she got older, she started to wonder where she originally came from and why she wasn't a mutant like her dad or brothers. A lovely evening in the city, the Ninja Turtles were standing on the roof of a building about to do a race. Okay, you guys ready? Oh, you know it! Bring it on! Let's do it! Hey, Big Brothers, is it okay if I join in? Just a second. The four huddled together. Should we include her? But if we do, she'll beat us with her flying! Well, Dad did say we should include her in everything we do. And she is our sister, so we should. Okay, but let's tell her not to use her wings. Okay, Saf, you can join. But there's one thing, you can't use your wings. No wings, no problem. Ready? 1, 2, 3, go! The brothers started to run and jump on each roof, one by one, while Sapphire was right behind them. But luckily, she knew a shortcut. Later, the four made it to the final building where their friend April O'Neil and her pet Mayhem were. Oh, good race, guys! So who won? Well, you all came in second. What? Then who came first? You might want to ask your sister. Sapphire then came up. Well, it's about time you four showed up. Sapphire, we said you couldn't use your wings. I didn't. Then how did you get here? You might want to look at this. April took out her phone to show a video she took of Sapphire making it to the building's roof without her wings. Wow, fascinating. Just then, there was a big crash heard from across the street. What was that? Looks like trouble in the city again. Let's check it out. Good idea. Hey, what about me? Can I help out? Actually, Sapphire, why don't you stay with April? Oh, okay. Let's go, guys. And with that, the turtles went to go check while Sapphire and April stayed on the roof of the building. Gee, I wonder what made that crash. What do you think, Sapphire? Sapphire? Sapphire didn't seem to feel very happy. Hey, is everything okay? Huh? Yeah, everything's fine. It's just, for the longest time, I've been wondering. About what? Like, where do I come from originally? What do you mean? Like, all the different things, like why do I have wings? And what is this sword that appeared on my butt when I was 5? And I know I'm adopted and so are my brothers. And I'm the only non-mutant creature in the family. So where could I really be from? Well, have you ever thought of asking them about all this? I would, but every time I say I need to ask you guys something, they always think that they haven't been good brothers to me as of lately. Well, you should ask them about it, even if they do that. Really? Yeah, do it. And if they think about that, just say, you guys are great brothers. I just want to know where I came from. Okay, I'll give it a go. Later, after checking out the crash, which was just a car crash, the five said goodbye to April and left for home. When they got to the sewer top, that was the entrance to their home, Sapphire was ready to ask them, hey, can I ask you guys something? Oh no. Sure, just give us a minute. The four huddled together. Great, now I think it's come. No, it hasn't. You guys have been good brothers to me. All I want to know is how I became your sister. Oh, well, gee, you know, I've been wondering the same thing. Yeah, and well, we don't really know. You're gonna have to ask Dad about that. Okay, then I'll ask him. Later, the five made it to the living room where their father Splinter was watching some old movies on a projector screen while drinking some tea. Hey, Dad? Ah, yes, Pink, what could I do for you? I want to know where I came from. After she said that, Splinter spit his tea out. What? I want to know where I came from. Oh, I knew this day would come. Sit down, Pink. You too, boys. Is it that serious? Well, yes, but pretty unexpected. Okay. Now, before I tell you, Sapphire, I'm going to use your species as an example. Wait, what? Now, you see, when a mommy Pegasus and a daddy Pegasus love each other very much, they get in bed together, and then the daddy Pegasus puts his, "No, Dad! She wants to know how she became a part of our family, like how she got adopted." "Oh, well, why didn't she just say so? So, how did it happen?" "All began 18 years ago, when your brothers were next in line to become the next Ninja Turtles. I remember when I first got the news, I was so happy, so to surprise them, I decided to get them gifts. So that night, I went out into town with a basket, which I filled with tons of goodies. And on my way back home, I was just about to pass an alleyway, when suddenly a zapping sound and screaming came from it. So I went in to check, and all I found was you, with two dead bodies that looked like they were electrocuted. And knowing you had no one to take care of you, I took you in, and that morning I surprised your brothers with you, and all those other goodies I got."
"Wait, I remember!
Yeah, and of course I was the most excited to finally get a sister.
So, my birth parents were electrocuted to death? How?"
"I don't know, and the weirdest part is, it wasn't even storming that night."
"Then, if it wasn't storming, then what killed them?"
"I don't know, I wish I did know, but I have one thing that will make you have a memory of them." Splinter then took out a wooden box. He opened it where the locket she had when he found her.
"It was around your neck when I found you."
She opened the locket and inside was a picture of her as a baby with two ponies.
"That's them with me.
Sapphire?" Later, Sapphire went into her room with the locket and her brothers right behind her.
"Hey, look, we know you're upset because of your birth parents being dead and all, but come on, at least now you have that locket Splinter gave you to remember them. And you have us."
"Guys, not helping.
It's not that. I just want to know who murdered them and why."
"That could be hard, but maybe there's a way."
"Cheer up, Sapphire. Just be happy you got us."
"I know, but I'm just not having it."
"Guys, I think it's best we leave Sapphire alone."
Her brothers then left the room, but before that, Leo turned back. "Sis, we love you no matter what. And as long as I'm the closest to you, I won't let anything happen to you." Then he closed the door. After they were gone, Sapphire took a look at the locket with the picture inside.
"I will find out who murdered them, even if it means facing danger."